spoke to my manager this morning, like you're saying, after the video shoot, I came back telling my management, I think there is an endorsement of Nana in the song, because the second verse, they talk about Nana Twaso. And the last bit of the song, which I didn't hear even when I was on set, because the song never got to the last bit of the song, or I didn't hear the Still the Battle is the Lord in the song whilst I was on set. But me being like a normal Ghanaian that understands everything that is going on in our country, knows that when you say Nana Twaso, it is something. I mean, the MPP people are using right now Nana Twaso for more for Nana. So I told my management that I think Sack did an endorsement for Nana on the song. He's like, ah, am I for real? And I said, yeah, because the second verse they talk about semi caste school, yeah, and then that you see, I'm a being a free education to Nana Twaso, because this is basically an endorsement. And they were like, oh, cool. So they will call Sack's management. So my manager called me this morning saying that they called Sack, they explained everything, and Sack says it's not an endorsement, it's from his own. This thing and this thing and this thing. So, yeah, that's how far the situation has been able to get to. But I know that he went for something, gave him something, or it was willingly. All I knew was I had no idea that Nana Twaso or Nana Still the Battle of the Lord was going to be in the song. All I knew was he sent me his first rap. So I listened to the rap to put together the chorus. Do you get me, Mizzy?
Yeah, I can hear you.
It was just the first rap, which has nothing to do with any Nana or anything with MPP. So I listened to his first rap and I wrote my chorus from it. So that's why I was singing, everybody give glory, Yesu Udom Yomini Noni, Gio, because we are giving you glory, bro. So me, it was a Thanksgiving song for me.
So when you got on set to shoot the video was when you got to hear the second verse.
100%.
You didn't raise concerns whilst you were shooting the video until you came to tell your team.
Okay, so... there is something about management that you don't fight your fight. You get it. And then this is not even a fight for me. This is just being able to confront their team as well, that this is what we think is going on, because this is what we've heard. And also, we have to confront them. I'm not the person to confront Sack.
So basically, if I understand you...
To management.
Yeah, so basically, if I understand you, you were mute all through the video shoot. You just...
Yeah. I was basically mute, because... I had to make it a management and a management affair. It shouldn't be an artist and a management affair, because I was there with my road manager, I mean, to escort me do the whole video. But my management, which meant Sam Albert, no one was at that very particular shoot. So I had to get to them later to contact Success Music. Because
and at that time, you had finished shooting the video.
Yeah, and I don't want to be a part of this whole thing. So I have to make it a management and a management affair.
Okay, we understand that. But
I didn't confront Sack. Yeah.
That's fine. But are you... from what you tell me, it looks like you're very uncomfortable with the political concerns that are being raised.
I think I have every right to be uncomfortable, because it's not about the fact that there is an endorsement or there isn't an endorsement. It's just the fact that I had no idea about it. And I am, as a human, I hate to be kept in the shadows. Do you get it? To do something that I have no idea about. That is the only thing that makes me uncomfortable. So right now, I'm actually in the middle of whatever is happening. But whether this is truthful or this is not truthful, I'm just in the middle. I don't know what's going on, but I'm an innocent young guy who just did a chorus for somebody I respect very much in the industry. So minim ni ekoso. So I'm getting a lot of people tweeting at me and all that, something I literally don't have any idea about. That is what I'm uncomfortable
are
about.
Are you disappointed that, like you said, you've been kept under, it's all happening, yet you cannot even defend what it is? Are you disappointed that you weren't told the detail?
I'm not disappointed. I'm just uncomfortable that I can't just, defend myself, because I have no idea. But I'm not disappointed, because it's craft. So I'm just uncomfortable. This whole thing is happening and I can't just help myself.
You feel it will have
I don't understand anything.
You feel it will have some effect on your career?
Of course, if it was done with a political idea, it will have an effect on my career. I'm not going to lie about it. I'm not going to keep quiet. Like, if it happens that way, I'm cool about it, because I wasn't ready. That's all. I wasn't ready to go vouch for any political party publicly. Do you get it? I wasn't ready. And if this is really how it's going to end, and by people from different